So the students were talking about the overview of entire anti-cancer drug, though you might have already read this in pharmacology. I'm correct? Am I correct?
Yes,
Pharmacology
sir.
over, no? In MC?
Yes, sir.
Medicinal chemistry?
In yes, sir, it's over,
Okay, so that means I can pick, gain my pace then. I shouldn't spend much time because this is just a recap of all the things that you have already read. In MC and pharmacology. MC, you read the structure of all the drugs. In pharmacology, the mechanism. Same thing, we are just recapping it so that it will become easier when we go to the leukemia and the breast cancer, all the things. Okay. So here we summarized in the last class, we summarized all the mechanism by reflecting or by telling you this is a central dogma. Almost all the drug action, some are one or other steps in this pathway. Then alkylating agent. Actually, if it would have been, if you interact more, because you already know from your MC and pharmacology, you know already about many of these drugs already. So you should be speaking in between if you have like it will help you to brush up and help me as well. So these alkylating agents will contain a chemical group that will bind covalently with the cell nucleus. Okay. So I hope you know what is nucleophiles from your chemistry. And these are important properties of drugs. Okay. These nucleophile, okay, this covalently binding to nucleophiles, and this can form a carbonium ion. And this carbonium ion is like carbon with six electron, which is highly reactive. And this react with this group, like an amino group, hydroxyl group, SH group. So this reacts with this group. And by that, it formed the cross-linking. Okay, this formed the cross-linking. And the important targets where it acts is G is for guanine. Okay, in the guanine at a nitrogen 7 position, this is the this is the target actually. And it can also target adenine at nitrogen 1 atom, adenine at nitrogen 3 atom, or cytosine at nitrogen 3. Okay, so this can be the target, and because of this cross linking, the DNA gets cross linked, maybe intra means same, or inter strand, and this will decrease the transcription and replication, as we saw here in the central dogma. In the transcription, and this is a transcription, and this is a replication, and this is transcription and this translation. If the transcription and translation doesn't happen, the protein cannot be formed, and cell material cannot be synthesized, and the cell will die. So, one basic thing, what we are doing, how we are treating the cancer is, tell me. The one statement answer I need, one two-word answer I need. How we are treating the cancer?
Stopping cell division.
We are killing the cancer cells. Okay, that's the overall idea of knowing the mechanism of any drug, any anti-cancer drug. Our main aim of giving anti-cancer drug is to kill the cancer cells. Okay, as effectively as we kill. And that effective is the drug. As effectively as it targets only cancer cell and spares the normal cell, that effective is the anti-cancer drug. Okay, so we are killing the cells. We are killing the cancer cell. So it may be by any way, any means. So here the means is decreased transcription or replication, and the chain and the strand breaks then. Okay, so there is inappropriate base pairing. If you remember, the A pair with T and C pair with G. You remember? ATCG,
Yes, sir.
A with T and C with G. So this is what will be the chain in the DNA double strand. So if there is inappropriate base pairing, instead of AT, if it is happening AC or AG, sorry, AT is the normal. Okay, AT is the normal. Instead of AT, if it is happening AG or AC, AG or AC, that's an improper base pairing, and that cannot again transcribed and replicated. And okay, I told you this blocks the transcription translation. So that's generally C S phase. Okay, that's generally S phase, and G2 phase, and it also blocks G2 phase and causes apoptosis. So you can see this is what we were talking in the previous slide. There is a improper pairing. This should not happen. Okay. Bifunctional alkylating agent can cause this intra-strand linking, again cross-linking. Because of that, it cannot replicate and transcribe effectively. So what is this?
Alkylating agent, nitrogen mustard.
Okay, yeah. If you remember from your pharmacology, it's a nitrogen mustard. So these are the structure. Again, you need to read in MC that. But the mechanism is it lose the chloride. Okay, this and this chloride causes the intramolecular cyclation of the chain, and this forms a reactive ethylene ammonium derivative, which reacts with the reacts with the material of cancer cell, and the cancer cell gets died. So one of the drug in nitrogen mustard is very famous drug, cyclophosphamide. Okay, this is very common drug. You have to know that this is a pro drug. What do you mean by pro drug, Dibya? Is Dibya? What do you mean by pro drug? You know?
I don't know exactly.
Okay, Arjun. Betsy.
It must be converted to the active form.
Yeah, since I think these are too much question for your MC, you'll get definitely. You should know there are many drugs which are not activated. Okay, which needs, you know, many drugs after metabolism gets deactivated. Okay, but there are some drugs which gets activated after metabolism. So these are called prodrug. Okay. So the idea of making prodrug is to save a drug until it reaches to the systemic circulation or to the liver sometimes. So here, this prodrug, cyclophosphamide prodrug, and it gets metabolized. That means it gets activated with the help of the cytochrome P450 enzyme, which is a mixed function oxidase enzyme. So it affects lymphocyte. So that is why it is immunosuppressant. You know, these are immune cells. And it is given by IV or oral usually. The side effects include nausea, vomiting, bone marrow depression, hemorrhagic cystitis. This is one of the important and very classical or typical side effect of cyclophosphamide. So you should know, I don't expect you to know all the side effect of all the drugs, okay? But I expect you to know the typical side effect of some drug, okay? Typical side effect of all the drugs, typical side effect. That means that only that ADR or that side effect happens because of that drug. If you see hemorrhagic cystitis with other anti-cancer drug, you may not find with other drug, or if you don't find as common as you find with the cyclophosphamide. So I expect you to know the general side effect, the general common side effect, so that you can counsel patient on that aspect. So if someone is talking about hemorrhagic cystitis in an anti-cancer patient, then the cyclophosphamide should come in your mind. Okay, so this happens because of a chemical that is acroline. Okay, so this acroline gets formed and deposited in the bladder, that causes hemorrhagic cystitis. Okay, so but this can be ameliorated with the help of SH donor if you give anything. Yes, Ravi. Hello, Ravi.
So, what is hemorrhagic cystitis, sir?
What is cystitis? I have talked, no UTI.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so you know the meaning of hemorrhagic, and I have taught a UTI where I have taught a cystitis. Hmm?
Yes, sir, I got it. Sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So, but it can be ameliorated with the help of this SS donor. That is, then this is. The acroline, okay, because of this, actually this hemorrhagic cystitis happens. So you can see all these things you will read in MC, but I just want to show this. Okay, this is the thing that causes hemorrhagic cystitis. So it gets activated by, this is a nitrosuria, the next class of drug. This gets activated in vivo, that is in the body. And this, again, it is alkylating agent, so it alkylates the DNA. But alkylation, because of alkylation, it produces many toxicity. Okay, so you can see here again. Yeah, okay. So this is the alkylated DNA. Okay, if it alkylates the proteins, for example, here, if it alkylates proteins, so then the toxicity happens mostly. The next drug is temozolomide. Temozolomide is again alkylating agent. So this methylates the guanine and adenine, specifically these two bases. And there is again improper GT base pairing. You know, the normal pairing is AT and CC. Okay, so A with T and C with G. So you can see this is not A with T and not C with G. So this is improper base pairing. This is how, again, the replication and transcription cannot happen, or translation cannot happen, and the cell will die. Again, there is a chance, you know, we are talking about checkpoints and repair. So even something like this happens, there is chances that it can get repaired. Okay, so but if that also doesn't happen, then the, it will go on. Okay, the cancer will continue. So next drug is cisplatin. Again, this chloride is dissociated from this, which is a reactive complex. It reacts with hydrogen and it interacts with DNA. Again, it cross-link at guanine and nitrogen 7 position, which adjacent to guanine 06 position. And this causes again denaturation of DNA. And one of the important side effects of cisplatin you need to note is nephrotoxic. Okay, this is highly nephrotoxic. So if the patient is having already some sort of kidney disease, probably not a preferable choice of this. That's why not a preferable choice. This has this drug. So there is severe nausea, vomiting, but that can be ameliorated with 5-HT3 antagonist. Okay. So can someone tell? But see, what is 5-HT3 antagonist?
Sir, it'll inhibit the.
Okay, just give me one example. Aishwarya? Babit? Super. Anybody?
Metoclopramide?
Ondansetron, okay. So this is 5-HT3 antagonist is ondansetron. This decreases the gastric motility. And then carboplatin, which have fewer side effects. So in compared to cisplatin, carboplatin have I'm not sure whether it is S2 5S2. Just check it. 5S2 is ondansetron. 5S2 3 and 5S2 3 antagonist is ondansetron. It's not metoclopramide. You made me confused. Just check it, Ravi. 5-HT3 is ondansetron, what I believe, but you are telling it as
5-HT3 is ondansetron.
Ondansetron, no, that's what metoclopramide.
Yes, sir. It's 5-HT3.
Okay. So carboplatin have fewer side effects when compared to cisplatin, but one of the major disadvantages of carboplatin is it is highly myelotoxic. What is myelotoxic, Julissa?
Yes, sir.
What is myelotoxic? So if you don't anything, just raise your hand. I will you know, wait there and explain. Okay, it shouldn't be okay. I'm speaking. You are not understanding anything. Myelo, you know what is myelosuppression?
Bone marrow suppression.
Okay. So myelo, what is there instead of suppression? Toxic, what is there? Okay, so myelosuppression is a milder form. Myelotoxic is a severe form of the same manifestation. Okay, so here. You will see the profound decrease in all the blood cells, okay, because this is again attacking the myelocytes or the bone marrow cells. Okay, then the next class of drug is antimetabolite. This is called antimetabolite because this mimics the structure of normal metabolic molecule. Okay, so what are these normal metabolic? I'm going to tell you. Like folic acid, you know. So these are normal metabolic molecule in the human body. So this kind of drug will mimic that, okay? And the cancer cell will get confused with that, and then it will use this drug instead of that normal metabolite, and the cancer cell gets killed. So this actually inhibits, as I told, then there will be confusion with the cancer cell. This inhibits the enzyme competitively, or it is included in into macromolecules. And because of that, there will be inappropriate structure. It kills the cells in S phase. Okay? And there are three main groups. One is folate antagonist. The second one is pyridine analogs. Third one is purine analogs. So these are the three main groups of antimetabolite. When you are talking about antimetabolite, you should know the names of drugs, which are folate antagonist, which are purine analogs, and which are pyrimidine analogs. So folic acid analog, Folic acid gets synthesized for synthesis of purine. Okay, folic acid is essential for purine synthesis. Actually, when you read anemia in the next year, you are supposed to understand, if you know this under this mechanism right here, it will be very, very helpful for you to understand even that anemia. There are, you know, there are many kinds of anemia. One of the anemia is folic acid deficiency anemia, or B12 deficiency anemia, which is a pernicious anemia. So there are many kinds of anemia, but if all every place, okay. As you know, the anemia is one of the common side effects of anti-cancer drugs. So if you know this common concept, if you know this common pathway, you can extrapolate this pathway to the anti-cancer drug, to the anemia, to explain, okay, what will happen to the folic acid if you give, what will happen to the vitamin B12 acid, and how that's going to prevent the many neurotoxic neuromuscular disease. So, and there is detailed mechanism, okay? If you have time, then you can go through in that detail, like how the absorption of folic acid and vitamin B12. From the absorption only, the story will start, but I will not take you from there, but I will tell you here what happens once it gets absorbed and into the cell. Okay, so here, the folic, what is folate? Basically, this is a pteridine ring. Plus PABA, which is para-aminobenzoic acid, plus glutamine. Okay, so these three things constitute the folate. Okay, and in cells, this gets converted into polyglutamates, because the folate cannot get absorbed directly. To get absorbed, it has to be in the poly stage. It gets combined and form polyglutamates, and then it gets converted into tetrahydrofolate, okay, FH4. So here the picture is about what? You can see the folic acid. This is a picture of folic acid.
Folate.
Yeah, folate or folic acid. So you can see here what happens. Let's look at the diagram now before reading the text. Then you'll understand text easily. So what is happening here is this is an enzyme called dihydrofolate reductase enzyme. Okay, and right now we are talking about this folate, okay, FS4. So this folate, this one carbon unit, and the purpose of you, before you go into detail of this diagram or any diagram related to this, you understand there is the purpose of doing all these reaction is only one. You should understand, okay, what is the end product, what happens, why we need all these kind of reaction here. So we need this reaction for only one purpose, that the purpose is to make DUMP. Okay, the purpose is to make DUMP from DTMP, and this gets formed. To form this, we need one methyl group, okay, and that methyl group is donated by FH4. Okay, so there's all the story here, all the reaction happens just for that one methyl group. So that, and this is the enzyme, in the presence of this enzyme, the methyl group is added to in DTMP, and then it makes dump. Okay, so we can
DUMP makes DTMP, right?
Okay, I'm sorry, that's what I was wondering. This is mono and this is this thing. Yeah, so thank you for correcting, Ravi. So this get dumped, this methyl group is getting dumped on this DUMP, and that gets converted into DTMP. Okay, so this DTMP is required for DNA synthesis. Okay, for thymidine, if you remember, one of the bases T, right? ATCG.
Yes,
so for that, this is required. Okay, for that, this is required. So all this happens just because of just for this. Okay, so if that means if this is formed, the DNA gonna form, they're gonna make a pairing, and the DNA gonna form. If this DTMP itself is not forming, that means that DNA is not going to form. So here you can see this is the two-step process. Folate is converted into dihydrofolate and then tetrahydrofolate, and this tetrahydrofolate serves as a methyl group donor. Okay, and that gets converted into DTMP with the help of thymidylate synthesis enzyme from DUMP. And it also generates one FS2 that gets again recycled. So this, if you have understood the this diagram, then it's very easy for you to understand now the mechanism of this empty metabolite like folic acid and thymidine. So here, this methotrexate have higher affinity for the enzyme than does FS2 have. So here you can see where this FS2 is getting converted to FS4. Here, right? FS2 is getting converted to FS4. So that means we are talking about this enzyme, dihydrofolate reductase enzyme. If you are giving a methotrexate, this methotrexate have higher affinity with this enzyme than the FS2 themselves have. So this is by like additional acts or ionic bond gets formed, and there is depletion of FS4 in the cell. Depletion of FS4 means this FS4 will be less, and then the depletion in DTMP. As I told, if this pathway is disrupted, this DTMP cannot be formed, and then there will be less thymine, and then cell will die because the DNA synthesis will gets inhibited. And this object will happen through folate transport system. If the cell is resistant, or if the cell is not uptaking the drug very nicely, that means the methotrexate not going to act. So, and this metabolites, polyglutamate derivatives, is going to return for the weeks and the months. So this is what I was showing with this comparison of structure between folic acid and methotrexate. You can see how similar both are. So this is pteridine ring, this is PABA, this is glutamate residue, and this is methotrexate drug. So this is normal folic acid, this is methotrexate drug. They are very, very similar. Okay, that is why they do act by competitive inhibitory mechanism. This is the same diagram that we saw in the previous slide. Okay. This is the next drug in this class, pimetrexate. Okay, so this is again, you can see the structure. This is folic acid, this is methotrexate, this is pimetrexate. So not much used pimetrexate, but methotrexate, we say it is a wonder drug. Okay, we use the methotrexate for many purposes, actually, not only for anti-cancer. We use methotrexate for, I think when we are discussing RA, there we discussed, we use even for RA, we use even for even in OBG cases sometimes, and we use methotrexate even in psoriasis. Psoriasis is again remaining chapter there also you will see this drug. So this have wide variety of uses. Okay, so this pimetrexate is not used that much, but you can see the structure, they are very much similar. This is how they antagonized. Okay, this is the same diagram, but I think this is what you have read in your pharmacology, PABA to folate and then DNA. So here in between these dihydrofolate reductase is coming. Okay, so if you remember from your pharmacology antibiotic chapter, there is another drug called trimethoprim which also acts on this enzyme. Okay, do you remember? And then sulfonamide also inhibit dihydrofolate synthesis. So finally, the ultimate goal is DNA is not getting formed and the cell is being killed. So this was about folate antagonists, and now let's talk about pyrimidine analogs. Okay, which is again another drug of which class?
Antimetabolite.
Antimetabolite. Okay. So 5-fluorouracil is a drug. Okay, this is a dump analog. As we saw in the previous picture, you can see how does dump look. So we are making a drug very similar to this. Okay. We are making a drug very similar to this, and something will happen here so that this will not be formed again. So the target again is this. You can see here what is happening here. We are making a dump analog, which again works through the DTMP synthesis pathway. This gets converted into fraudulent dump. That's what this is, fake and dump. This is not the actual dump. There will be the competitive inhibition for thymidylate synthetase active site, but can't be converted into DTMP. Okay, so it cannot be converted into DTMP, but it will compete with this enzyme. So it will slow down the enzyme. The fraudulent dump will slow down this enzyme and cannot be converted to DTMP. So finally, DTMP we need for the DNA. So that is not getting formed, and the DNA will not form, and the cell will get killed. So here it also uses other mechanism. It also finally decreases the transcription translation rather than They're saying the meeting will end in 10 minutes. Let's see, I have upgraded it. So it decreases synthesis, and it also, because DNA is not getting formed, of course, the transcription and translation is going to be decreased. The next drug is gemcitabine, which is phosphorylated triphosphate. Okay, this is again fraudulent nucleotide. You know what is nucleotide and what is nucleoside? I was explaining the difference in the last class. So this is a fake nucleotide. Okay, so you know nucleotide and nucleotide are the backbone of the DNA. So if you are inserting a fake nucleotide into the sequence of that DNA base pair, so definitely that will break the chain, and the DNA is not going to replicate or translate. So this is something similar that we have used even in AIDS, if you remember. Non-nucleoside and non-nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So there also it was non-nucleotide and non-nucleoside. Okay. So something very like fraudulent kind of nucleotide we made. So here it also inhibits ribonucleotide reductase, and finally there is decreased nucleotide synthesis. Another drug is capecitabine. The difference between gemcitabine and capecitabine is capecitabine is prodrug. It is again converted to 5-fluorouracil that we saw in the previous slide. Okay, 5-fluorouracil that we saw in here. So pyrimidine analog. So this is the only difference between gemcitabine and capecitabine. For the conversion of capecitabine to 5-fluorouracil, and even 5-fluorouracil to get degraded, there is a need of enzyme. Okay, and the need that enzyme you can look. Okay, that is very important enzyme because it is a rate limiting enzyme in the effect of in short we call it DPD. Okay. This is that's a rate limiting enzyme for the effectiveness of this capecitabine drug. So this is what the structure of capecitabine getting converted into active form. Then the next drug is cytosine arabinoside. This is also called cytarabine. Okay, cytarabine. So this is analog of 2-DC. Okay. And this is 2-DC is 2-deoxycytidine, okay, 2-deoxycytidine. And this is the mechanism how it acts is it is phosphorylated in vivo. That means again it is it gets activated by the help of phosphorylation into the cell, and it inhibits the DNA polymerase. So you know what is the purpose of DNA polymerase enzyme? Do you know?
DNA replication.
Yeah, so it inhibits again the polymerase enzyme through which the replication cannot happen. So this gemcitabine and gemcitabine have fewer side effects, okay, when compared to other drug of the same class. You can see this is the structure of gemcitabine. And next coming to the purine analog. So purine analog are 6-mercaptopurine. Do you remember we had discussed the same drug somewhere else also? In our previous chapter. Febuxostat. Did you get something?
Gout, sir. Gout.
Gout.
What gout? Gout. Okay, gout. You have gout. Okay, so there, and when we are discussing about interaction with febuxostat with azathioprine, this azathioprine is nothing again. Very, very similar to 6-mercaptopurine. So 6-mercaptopurine, 6-thioguanine are purine analog. This gets again converted into fraudulent nucleotide. Okay, so the mechanism goes same as we discussed in the. So this is purine, that is pyrimidine. Only that's the difference. The mechanism goes same. Ultimately, DNA cannot be replicated and translated. The cell will die. So the example are fludarabine and pentostatin. The next class of drug is cytotoxic antibiotics. These are this is antibiotic. You know, all antibiotics, most of the antibiotics are either synthesized or from microbial origin. So this inhibits the cell division. Under this antibiotic classification, cytotoxic antibiotic classification, first is anthracycline. The drug is doxorubicin. Okay, it intercalates the DNA. And it prevents again the replication by acting on topoisomerase 2 enzyme. Okay, so this again, as I was telling, the purpose of this topoisomerase 2 is it prevents the entangling of the DNA among themselves. Okay, so this since DNA is very long in length, there is high chance that it can get entangled among itself. So this topoisomerase 2, what it does is it cuts wherever entangled has happened, and then it uncoiled and then corrects it. So, but if that's a normal process, but if this topoisomerase 2 enzyme itself is inhibited, okay, is inhibited, then definitely that correction cannot happen into the helix, and then the replication and translation will not happen. So I hope now you are realizing the importance of me showing this, that central dogma and overview where all the drug acts. So all the drugs act somewhere and some point in that central path only. So the next drug is epirubicin, mitoxantrone. These are structurally related side effects. This is one of the common side effects of basically all anthracycline class of antibiotics. Cardiotoxic, okay? These are very cardiotoxic, and sometimes it is contraindicated because of that. And of course, it causes bone marrow. The cardiotoxicity is because of free radical production. Next drug in the same class is daclonomycin. It is again acting by same mechanism. But it also interferes with RNA polymerase movement, and because of that, transcription doesn't happen. And this may also work again by same as doxorubicin by inhibiting the topoisomerase 2. And the next drug is bleomycin. Okay, when I say bleomycin, what do you recall from your MC? I have very, very significant memory with bleomycin and MC. When someone talks bleomycin and MC, that's why I'm asking you. Whenever someone talks bleomycin, I remember this is the toughest structure in the MC that one can make actually. So I remember for our class, I think sir had taken half an hour just to draw the structure. So that complex it is, but with practice, you will get well versed with. But very tough. I think your teacher will recommend not to spend much time on this, just to understand and then go for some other structure practice rather than spending time on this. This is very complex structure. Okay, so these are glycopeptide antibiotics. This chelates with Fe, which is iron, and interacts with O2. There is generation of, as you are seeing, this FeO2R, the free radical generative atoms. So this generates the superoxide and hydroxyl ion. And this through this, the radical degrade the DNA, and the DNA gets fragmented, there will be free bases, and the cell cannot further divide. Okay. So this is most effective in G2 phase. And there is little myelosuppression, but pulmonary fibrosis is again main issue with the bleomycin. Okay, one of the again typical side effect of bleomycin is pulmonary fibrosis when compared to all other side effects. So this is the structure of bleomycin I have there. So you can see how complex it is, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So before we move to the plant alkaloid, you need the breath. Because I think waiting time remaining showing 1 minute.
When will take class?
Immediately after 2 minutes, I will again send a new link so that you can join.
Yes, okay.
Is that okay? Okay,
yes,
you can go for a 2 minute break. I will share a new link.
Okay, sir.